If you guys have watched any of our videos before, you would know that I love our Victron charging gear. So I'll spin you guys around so you can have a look. We've got the DC-DC charger and the MPPT controller. Now, this unit, solar charge controller, is a 20 amp unit, as is the little cheap Atem Power one. So the rules are going to be pretty simple. Our system runs our solar through a regulator, through a shunt, and then into the 120X Pro battery down here. So it's going to be very easy to monitor. We're not going to take any readings from this Bluetooth unit. We're going to take all of our readings from the shunt just before the battery here, and we're going to just compare the two readings of both solar controllers. So let's get straight into it. I've made sure that everything else is turned off on the other side of the canopy, but let's turn the solar charge controller on and see exactly how much power we're putting in. So this is what I love about this Victron unit as well. It's so easy to use and muck around with settings and things like that and customize to any setup that you want. All right, so you guys should be able to see that on screen now. We're putting in around that 4.5 amp mark. Pretty good, around the 60 watts. So what we're gonna do is just leave this run for 5 minutes and see what the average is. So I'm just gonna keep a close eye on this and I'll time lapse this so you don't have to sit here 5 minutes watching it, but we'll see what this does over 5 minutes and then we'll swap the regulators and see what the other one does. So hopefully you guys saw the value really didn't change that much. It was just floating around that 4.5, 4.6 amps going into the battery. So pretty good result. For 110 watts, I think it was putting in, average of about 60, which is pretty good. It's only fairly early, it's only 10:30. The sun's not all the way up in the sky yet. So it's not too bad of a result, to be honest, with the Victron unit. So let's swap over to the Atem Power unit and see how that one goes. We've got the Atem Power regulator hooked up and it's charging away now. So we're sitting at 4.78 amps. So pretty good. It's actually better than the Victron was. Not by much, only by what, 0.2 of an amp. So bugger, it could just be that it's a little bit brighter. It's been 20 minutes changing it over from one to the other. So that's pretty incredible though, that it's doing the same, if not better than the expensive Victron charger. But anyway, we'll leave it for 5 minutes again and come back to it and see what it's done. Far out. All right, so I'll just jump in, compare the trends now. I reckon we're gonna be pretty surprised, to be honest. All right, so I'll cut this on the screen now so you guys can see it as well, but I'll just jump into the trends and go for the last 5 minutes and we'll compare voltage and current. So you guys can see there, if I just take that back along the line and I'll just zoom right in. So if you look at the trend here, this is the Victron unit over the 5 minutes. So it started there, ramped up to 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, and then sort of topped out and leveled out at 5.5. And the voltage was just ever so slowly climbing up, 13.33, 34, and then we turned it off and changed it over. So we'll just jump forward here to, I'm not sure what's happened with the shunt, but this has actually been the case for the whole test. It shot up to 4.6 and 13.39 volts, and it's just held that for the whole 5 minutes. And sorry, up until right there, it's gone to 4.7 amps. And I actually did see it get to 4.8 as well. So that's actually pretty cool. This cheap little solar controller has outdone the Victron one. I don't actually think I believe it. I'm gonna go back and change it over again. I'm gonna do this test one more time. So we'll change back over, do the Victron again, because it might just be, as the sun's coming up, we're getting more coverage on the panel. So I just wanna make sure that's the case, that this little charge is not that much better than this Victron one. But anyway, I'll change them over, we'll do the test one more time, and we'll have a look at the results. All right, so I've just swapped it back over again. I've made sure that we are definitely on the Victron. Now, I'll just jump into the Victron app. I'll cut this on the screen so you guys can follow along with what I'm doing. Let's go back into the shunt, see what that's doing. All right, so you can see on the screen there, guys, that it's just over 5 amps. So I think it probably is that the sun's just coming up, so it's getting a bit more exposure as the day goes on. So that's probably why it seemed like the other one was performing better than the Victron. But in saying that, I'd go so far as to say that the Atem Power was at least on par with the Victron unit. It was at least doing just as good of a job. So that actually is really impressive. All right, we'll swap it over one more time. That's the number for right now. So the Victron is up to just over 5 amps, 5.03, we'll call it 5 amps. If this little Atem Power can crack 5 amps right now, I'll be really blown away. All right, so there it is on the screen. That's the Atem Power MPPT controller. 4.97 amps. Are you serious? It's 4.98. It's close enough to five, we'll call it 5 amps. The difference between the output is that small that you would never notice it. It wouldn't matter what you were running, you would not notice that in your solar system. I am absolutely blown away. I can't believe that that is putting out the same amount of power as my expensive Victron unit. And oh, mate, far out, man. If you're looking to build a budget solar setup, I don't think you could look past one of these little Atem Power charge controllers, because that has blown me away. Atem Power or Vicoffroad, they haven't paid me to say any of this. I just was really curious to see how this went, righto. So that actually surprised me a fair bit. The little Atem Power regulator, it blew my expectations away, honest to God. But in saying that, would I swap that for my Victron smart shunt? No, I probably wouldn't. It doesn't have all the fancy bells and whistles that the Victron one does. It doesn't have the Bluetooth. It doesn't have complete customizable settings that you can change for any purpose that you see fit. It does have a lot of stuff missing that the Victron one does have. But in saying that, if you are looking for a budget-friendly, good quality charge controller that is MPPT and lithium compatible, then you've got to check this one out. Because when it all boils down to it, it comes down to what your regulator is going to put into your battery. And that thing just stacked up really bloody well.